Okay, make sure everyone has had an opportunity to speak in your group and share some ideas. Okay, let's pause. I'd like to hear back from you. What are some of these ideas? And I really didn't dive into historical context that much, so I want to hear from you first. What are the ways that master narratives show up in the classroom? What are these ideas?
To catch myself as a teacher in a classroom around the comments I was making to boys and girls along gender lines. So I remember very distinctly catching myself once before saying it. I was gonna say, hey, what cute shoes you have to a girl. So I always think about, do I talk about girls in the form of how they look or how they dress? And do I talk about boys and their performance in classroom? And their proclivity towards math or science. I mean, that's constantly rung in my head. How am I thinking about students along gender lines?
We were just talking between ourselves about celebrations, the way that schools, have celebrations. And we all know that, you know, we no longer say Christmas or whatever, it's the winter break or whatever, but trying to have more diverse celebrations, and how do we do that? We have to invite, the parents to come in and other people. And I know for my school particularly, I notice it can change because we've had some holidays. We have one holiday that we still do, yet we have no one from that culture at our school at the moment. But it really took hold because everybody enjoyed it so much, right? So. But it was a way to break out of that master narrative, I guess, of only certain holidays being celebrated or whatever.
I was just hearing that a couple of things. One is that in our schools, our kids very much and quickly get the idea of who is supposed to succeed in what and not, and who isn't. So if you go into certain classes, you won't see very many of some kids. And if a kid is in a class with people who don't look like them, who supposedly are supposed to do better, they pretty much go along with that idea, and they don't put the effort in. And so that's one. And then, unfortunately, sometimes the master narrative happens at home. You know, and particularly in some of our cultures that relates to gender issues, the fact that maybe a young lady has all of the capabilities to be successful isn't appreciated. And so she even has to work to empower herself when she's not even getting the supportive message in her own community or in her own home sometimes, so.
I want to speak to the system of inequity. Is anyone familiar with that system? Dr. Shakti Butler's work. These narratives are really planted. I just want to draw the connection that they're planted by choice making that happened years, centuries ago, yes? And so deliberate choice making to oppress people to go and seek and discover and oppress, right? So these things have carried throughout us. They're in our bodies. They come up in every sector of our society. And so this is one particular way, this collaboration, Alphabet Rockers has found a way to disrupt those narratives because we are at such a beautiful point where we can interrupt the system of inequity. So I'm going to let you continue.
Yeah, great. We'll talk about this. You don't know children's music as being, let's talk about skin color mom or parent, right? How many, raise your hand if you heard songs that had positive affirmations about dark skin color growing up.
Or any skin color.
The message is that children's music have, like most of us, I can assume, the master narrative of children's music is a white dominant, boy-girl, binary narrative that's very colonial. I mean, all this stuff about it, like, we're not about that, right? I mean, none of us in this room is like, oh, I can't wait to play Yankee Doodle for my kids. If you are, let's check that, because I don't know. It's not for us. And so when Tommy and I started collaborating with Mariah, we were like, we want to take things to another level, like, and somebody who believes in the power of music to embody a shift in the master narrative, then we're really talking. When we talk about movement, changing the way you feel about yourself, even though people are telling you you're not good enough, you're not tall enough, whatever, you're like, I feel this way. You've got it in your body, so we're all standing up now.
Yeah.
And we're gonna make y'all feel and love that self that you live in, all of those intersectionalness. And Tommy, you wanna beatbox a little, or what did you just say? All right, cool. So we have this song that we wrote with Mariah's help, of course, inspired by my nephew at the time in preschool. Nobody would say his name correctly. End of the first week of school, they're still not saying his name correctly. Is this school for you? No. Is that okay? No. Let's give our educators a little bit more support. So this is a name song like that goes, hey, what's your name? Hey, what's your name? Hey, what's your name? Yeah, that's your name. Wear it. Hey, what's your name? What's your name? Hey, what's your name? Yeah, that's your name. Wear it out. All right, those are the words, basically. And then we have these dance moves, which we're going to teach you. So put your arms up in two lines and make a box. Luckily, we have this YouTube video if you want to do it with your class. Slide it across and flatten it out. This little tutting move, we call it the sandbox. There you go. On the beat right here, it goes like this. We do the sandbox. Yeah, you got it. We do the sandbox. Now we're going to switch it up and we just stack the blocks up. You're all, that was the hardest move. Don't worry about it. Do the spinning top. That's nice. You know that one. You put your rocks up. The rock stands for justice for all people. We know this. Say it to our kids. And it also stands for being a rock star. Are you a rock star? All right, rock stars of all abilities, make a meatball. If that means your meatball's here, cool. If it's down low, get your stretch. This is my meatball today. When I was pregnant, it wasn't this. And the spaghetti. Take your rock and throw it to the stars. And then we'll say, are you ready? You'll say, yeah. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Who wants to come on stage?
We only need six of you.
We need five more people. You're number one, two.
One, two, three, four.
Three, four. Two more. Two more, five, one more. All right, Ron. Make a line right here in between the podium and the DJ table. Let's introduce them. Everybody says, hey, what's your name? On beat, like this. Hey. Hey, what's your name?
Gina.
What's your name?
Lisa.
What's your name?
Ron.
Yeah, that's your name. Wear it out.
Hey, what's your name?
Alicia.
Hey, what's your name?
Barbie.
Hey, what's your name?
Saki.
Yeah, that's your name, wear it out. Wave line. Your hands for a second and get ready to rock it. And here we go. We do the sandbox, stack the blocks up, do the spinning top, put your rocks up, do the meatball and the spaghetti. All my rock stars, are you ready? All right, that was hot. I wasn't expecting so much amazement, but we did get it. One more time.
Hey, what's your name?
Saki.
Hey, what's your name?
Barbie.
Yeah, what's your name?
Alicia.
Yeah, that's your name. Wear it out.
Hey, what's your name?
Ron.
Hey, what's your name?
Lisa.
Hey, what's your name?
Gina.
Yeah, that's your name. Wear it out. Throw some shine in the air and on yourself, too. Be proud of yourself. Let's dance. One, two, three.
Do the sandbox. Stack the blocks up. Do the spinning top. Put your rocks up. Do the meatball and the spaghetti. All my rock stars.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, the student is the teacher. Y'all are gonna be the ones that say, hey, what's your name? The audience is gonna say it back to you. Say your name loud and proud. Six times.
Hey, what's your name? Hey, what's your name?
The sandbox,
stack the blocks up, to the spinning top. Put your rocks up to the meatball and the spaghetti. All my rock stars,
are you ready?
One more time. Sandbox, stack the blocks up to the spinning top. Put your rocks up to the meatball and the spaghetti. All my rock stars,
are you ready?
Say your name, wear it out.
Say that.
Say your name, wear it out.
Walk in a circle, walk around the block, or roll around the block. Walk around the block and tap it out. There you go. Thank you, friends on stage. And just so you know, the kids have spoken, the dab is dead. Sorry about that.
Yeah. If you're just learning the dab, it's already passed. Sorry for you.
Yeah, so names are important, right? Has anyone here changed their name in their lifetime? Beautiful. Has anyone had their name changed for you without your consent? Yeah, there's lots of ways we navigate them. As educators, we don't know people's story. We have a responsibility to believe them. I know that for us, this song is fun, right? We've had a student come up here and announce to the school that they're non-binary by changing what name they were presenting as. And we were like, okay, they were like, well, Tommy was the one holding the mic in space with them. And they were like, well, I got this name or this name. And Tommy said, what name do you want to use today? And I was like, this is the one, Eli. And 500 people say, we see you, Eli. What does that feel like?
Well, I got to say something that was really, really interesting. I observe a lot. And I noticed that all the kids already knew, but a lot of the teachers were like, Tanisha's Eli? I'm all, what? How do y'all know? Yeah, but everybody else knew. Everybody else knew. I want to tell y'all another story, too. It has to do with skin color. We were at a library one time, and this young lady came up to me. I think she might have been, was it Vietnamese? And her brother, they were, like, really close in, like, really, like you know, libraries, close quarters. But she walked up to me, and I am singing my heart out. and she says,
why are your lips brown?
I'm like, hold on, I'll tell you in a second, but I gotta bust this verse. Why are my lips brown? Why are my lips brown? I'm all thinking about it the whole time. Why are my lips brown? Why are my lips brown? You know? And we finished the song. As soon as he finished the song,
why are your lips brown?
Like, okay, because I'm brown. I just had to come out with something. I was all, I'm brown. That's why my lips are brown. Yes. And she was like, oh, okay. Yeah.
Meanwhile, I'm sitting over there listening, and I was like, oh, yeah, we're doing that thing we talked about backstage. Okay, it's happening. This young little brother, I'll assume, comes up and says, am I brown? Now, how am I going to decide that? I'm like, I'm not living in your body. How do you identify? This is not what I said out loud, my friends. That's in my brain going. And I was like, what do you see? We took a selfie, right? You know, this was the age where we really selfied a lot.
Like, oh yeah.
Big old selfie.
With the kids and everything.
And brothers, like, let me see that picture. Wait, there's something on my face. Like, there's some dust on my face.
We didn't get that at first. But then we started to notice, wait a minute, this kid actually thinks that we look the same. And he's wondering why he has that dust in his face because we're not the same. He's like, I'm brown. Me and Tommy are brown. And he just like was like, oh, well, next picture, I'll look like Tommy, you know? And he kept saying, I had dust on my face. And I was like, wow, this is interesting. We got to take this somewhere, you know?
So many layers. So we talked to Mariah, like, we want to do these songs that actually center skin color in that experience. We want y'all to step up and center skin color in the way we talk to one another right now. Before we get into play, can we make a safe space to share our first experiences of race? This were these two kids' first experiences of race, in a way. Maybe they've had some with other cultures as well, but let's, for the moment, say that that's a memorable moment at age 3 and 7. We just went into a school, asked the same question to parents, and dad's hand went up and said, my kid's 5, and her sister is 7, and we're talking about mixed heritage because they get treated differently based on one showing up as more Latina and one showing up as more white. And here they are side by side with another parent who's like, I haven't talked to my kids at all. So we all bring different truths, right? So let's take a moment, talk to your neighbor, same master narrative partner, should we do?
Yeah, can I offer an opt-out?
Yes.
I'm just gonna offer an opt-out if you are a person of color, but the opt-out is this, because I know that we are asked to talk about these stories all the time. We hold them, we walk around in them every day. So I want you to make a choice for yourself. If you can go with whatever story you want, you can think about someone else, all right? And it's if you claim that or not.
That's good. Y'all in, let's go.
Hit it.
I love how red. If you haven't passed the mic, please pass the mic to your other partners. If you need more time, say, oh, please. All right, final thoughts with one another. All right, so thank your partner for being for sharing or not sharing, honoring our experiences. And we just want to see hands if your first knowledge around race was 0 to 3. Four
ages.
And you can just put a hand up, 4 to 6. 7 to 9. Middle school. Or 10, sorry, if 10 was the year. Middle school. High school. After high school. Yeah.
There it is. Just also wanted to just say one thing about the conversation that you folks are having. I don't know about the comfort levels of anyone. The things can get uncomfortable sometimes with these conversations, or they could be very comfortable. What needs to be comfortable or uncomfortable is that conversation happening with a child as well. And we're educators, so I mean, I was kind of preaching to the choir. We're all thesauruses, right? So we can figure out other words to say. You know what I mean? You know, and so that's think about having that same comfort level and preparing our children for what they are, you know, about to see, or probably already currently seeing.
And actually, what we found was we were actually really scared to have this conversation, to go from hip hop education, which is about equity and which is for the people and of the people, into like specific namings. And so when we started, I just want to flip this up and I actually want y'all to hear the first song that we did, which is called Gimme Some Skin. I'm hoping it's here. And when we started writing this, we just wanted us to be able to name it. So while we play this song, we're gonna have an activity for you. Are you down?
Yes.
With your partners, we're gonna celebrate our skin colors. And the reason I wanna do this is show you, you can always go further with yourself and with one another. And we're going to give our skin color, just look at it, and what does it look like in the world or in this room?
We're not looking for colors like in the crayon box or, you know, if your skin looks red, what kind of red? Is it strawberry? Is it little red Corvette red? Is it kind of the chair? You know, is it, my nickname is carne asada. And I think it's a pretty good carne asada. That's how I like my carne, you know.
And mine is that like, tomato tortilla they have sometimes that like you don't actually order, but you know, so we got to put something together. Now mind you, sometimes making yourself and your body into something that you can eat or that is not of you is not something to make you feel good, because mixed folks often are holding this like, well, you're not this, you're chocolate light, or you're this, and so this might be not the exercise for you. If this feels like a safe engagement, go into it. If it's not, just be like, cool, this is for you. Does that sound right? But we'll show you what we did with it.
Yes, so we created what we call the ultimate high five, right? So we do our rock star handshake.
That's the one we came up with.
Do with you, rock star, and then we put toast.
That's something in common.
Yes, and then carne, oh, let's chop that John carne up. Don't dab, they don't dab anymore.
So we wanted to make something that we could play with in a diverse community. We invite you to try this, we'll put some music on. Take your thing in common you made a handshake with earlier. Add on your skin color nicknames and make something. Good luck, you have 2 minutes, let's go. This is Spitfire, quick.
Skin color is my skin color is your skin. I need a hand. beauty through eye contact. Man, human is human. We have the same parts. Skin tones are different, but not too far apart. Every high five is special because we are the colors together. They raise the bar, bringing us together. Dropping that guard. Give me that rock. I'll show you that star.
All right, last pizzazz, and then it's show and tell time, if you feel like it, as you're a little practicing.
If you are willing to share your handshake, come up to the front with us. Who else? They look kind of lonely up here. That wasn't even it. That wasn't even it. All right, so can you tell us your nicknames first?
Well, I'm Caramel.
Hey there.
And I'm Coffee.
Coffee Caramel.
Coffee Caramel. Yes, please. Fifth Avenue.
Yes.
Thank you.
Center stage for y'all.
And then, if you can tell us your...
Snowy Mountaintop.
No explanation necessary.
Café con leche.
Yes. And can we see it? Very nice.
Tommy, that reminds me, we go to schools, right? And we do this as our school assembly, part of the school assembly. And we'd have kids who'd come up and they'd have like a 10-part handshake that they brought in. And then at the end, they'd be like, oh yeah, and yeah, coffee. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
So we're making this a part of our master narrative as artists and humans, as like, and this is language that I'm learning from Mariah, to be honest, so I'm practicing it too. If I do it wrong, please help me. But like, we want to make it real comfortable to talk about our differences and start with a place of loving ourselves. So we're creating our own like framework for like, if we love one another, then is it, I mean, ourselves, is it possible to love one another? Is that where the empathy starts? And what we found is this song is great, but it didn't acknowledge power. Is it missing? And so we were like, oh, yeah, okay, well, here's how I would talk about power. And here's how I'd talk about power. And then we realize that we have different narratives that we actually are holding in our bodies. So we want to just play a little reflection for you. Is that cool?
Sounds similar, but they're different.
It's not convenient, is it?
All right.
That's okay.
Let's talk about it. So much to learn. I wanna know.
What is my color? What is my skin tone? What is its history? What is its culture?
What is my culture? What is my color? What is my skin tone? Why do we label?
What do I stand for?
What? What is my legacy? What is my legacy? What does it mean to you? What does it mean to me?
My people.
Let's talk.
Are you my people?
talk.
Are you my people?
Nah, let's stop talking and ask questions.
Stop
questions.
Thank you. One thing I know is we're all coming from different places. We all have, as my friend over here is really illuminating for me, blind spots. So for me, at 14, I had a lot of blind spots. What is my culture? It's not the ethnic names that I have from two generations back. What is this culture I'm living in the skin? It didn't make sense to me when I started seeing how racism was at work. And I felt like if I don't understand the culture and the heritage and this real ugly past that actually I'm walking into and as privilege, I can't be a friend. And I actually just can't accept any day in this life because it doesn't add up. And it's like once you see, you can't unknow. And so that's where I wanted to share in that song, which was written for children.
Oh yeah, we're kids hip hop. So in light of all of these things, well, one thing that we maybe have mentioned is that part of our process is we are very inquiry based. We talk to our community, we ask them what they need, what they wanna hear in music to help them be empowered, what they need to have exposed to the world that maybe everybody doesn't know about. When we were asking like people like my son, he was like, you know, I want to talk about like race and like we want to talk about how we can make it fall apart and all these things, you know. He was having issues, you know, preschool, he heard the N-word the first time, kindergarten, he was told he wasn't Mexican. And on top of that, if you were Mexican and black, we hate black, all black people are criminals. In the second grade, he heard Black Lives Don't Matter and all these things. And so we had to prepare him for those comments and for those things. And it started to feel very heavy to us. And we didn't want it to be a heavy thing. We wanted to like create music with joy. And so what we did was we recognized all of those things as shade. And so we just decided we want to throw shine, right? That's what we want to do. We're going to throw shine on shade. That's why we say, throw some shine on yourselves, throw some shine to people, right? That's actually become a thing. We see people walking down the street, they're all, hey! We're like, yes, get it, gotcha, you know? You know, yeah. So throw some shine. And if you're feeling it yourself anytime, you say, man, I really like what I just said, or what I just thought.
Yeah.
Anyway, so we want to sing, we're going to do this song called, oh, no, we're not gonna do this song. No, because we wanna like dial it back a little bit and actually think about this because my son's teacher had a lot that she could do when these things happened, and there was things that she didn't have any idea of what to do. And so as teachers and as educators, what are those things in the classroom, you know, that are master narratives like? I know, like, for my kid, we always have to pay attention to make sure that he's actually, like, not sitting in the corner and all of the privilege is over here. You know, we got to go do surprise visits and see, hey, oh, yeah, how you doing? Okay, good, you know? What are some of those things?
And I think we wanted to do, like, a little workshop.
Yeah, I think we're ready. So I just want to name so Tommy's son is Little Tommy, and Little Tommy's teacher, you know, has the benefit of having Big Tommy. So that's, you know, as being privy to the story. That teacher had a way in to collaborate. And so we want to offer you a way in to collaborate, because this is about collaboration. We've been modeling our collaboration process here between professionals. But how can you collaborate with the album itself to address the narratives that you spoke about earlier? So there might be another master narrative now that you want to think about. Maybe a new one has emerged for you. But I want you to really workshop in groups of three or four. Shall we do four or three? What feels good? Okay, four. I'm hearing four. Great. So in groups of four, we're going to give you the link to the album. So you get to see some of the curriculum that has been developed. You get to see lyrics from the songs. And I want you to take a minute on whatever device you have you might need to share. So you're going to take a few seconds or a few minutes to yourself to go over that, and then workshop with the people in your group. How can you collaborate with this album, with this work, to address a master narrative in your classroom? Is that clear? All right, we're going to start. I'm going to check in 10 minutes. So give yourself two or three Great. Minutes to look at the offerings from Alphabet Rockers.
It's a bit.ly right there. Make sure you do the...
It's down at the very bottom of that corner.
Capitals and the lowercase. Case sensitive. As am I.
And I heard a question. What was the question?
Do you know the Wi-Fi here?
It's just open.
Stanford Visitor is the best one to use.
You have to hit accept, I believe.
So give yourself a few minutes and then get in your groups, and we'll check back in about 10 minutes.
And we're going to put up an example up here of how we created, and then I'll come back to you, Ren. How do we interrupt the everyone belongs here, we are the people narrative? And so this is the example of what our educators created as a activity to shift how we feel at home. And then we'll just put the song on so you can hear where we were coming from. It's called Walls, and you can do whatever you want.
Yeah, I do identify as American. I've lived in this country since I was 5.
The link still?
And there's no
okay,
amount
just a
of
moment.
Papers that can take that away from me. This is home.
We're gonna pass
this
the link out.
This is the only home I've ever known.
Question. Are we the people? Ask the question. Are we the people? Are we the people? That we wanna be. That we wanna be. That we wanna be. Not a border, not a wall, not a line in the sand could devise a plan to divide us again. No hay pared que puede parar. Comunidad, humanidad, paramos juntos, no pueden amenazar. Todos nosotros no somos solos. We are familia. My parents lead a life to feed us right, even when sometimes all that we can eat is the beans and rice. It's like we take pride.